Let me show you how you can create a top end report in Power BI with a variable end so that you can show the numbers and the detail for top 10, top 50, or top 100 customers or products or anything else, and still have it fully interactive so you can slice and dice it any which way you want. This is part of our top end playlist where we would be covering a lot of different topics around the top end theme. You would be able to access the complete playlist at the end of this video. So let me recap the content we have covered so far in previous top end videos. We figured out how we can apply a top 10 filter to see the details, for example, the top 10 customers. And then we also figured out how we can use that in a top end function to get the numbers about our top 10 customers. So the sales coming from them, the percentage sales, and so forth, see the trend. And in the next step, we took this, the top end function, and made that variable. So we could see the numbers coming in from our top 10 customers, but then change that to see, hey, what's the contribution for our top 50 or top 100 customers. All right, there we go. So what we're trying to do next is take this approach where we're able to vary the top 10, 50, 100, 5, 25, whatever you want, and be able to apply that to this filter. So let me set up that sheet and we'll take it up from there. So I have combined the two different elements as we have the measures using the top end function, which shows us the number. So top 10 customers are contributing $98,604 in our sales. That is 0.6% of our overall sales. So it has a number, and in the previous video, we have made that to be dynamic. So we can change that to 20, 50, 100, or whatever else we want. Now I have brought in the second element, and this is not dynamic. So this is our goal for this video, to take this list of detail showing the customers, and right now you can see that I'm showing top 10 customers, but if I switch 20, the rest of the report, the top end portion changes, but this one still stays at top 10. So we're gonna change this. And by the way, as always, any of the files shown in my video, you can just go to learnpowerbi.com/download and get the file so you can follow along, examine it in more detail. So if we look at this, and if you remember how we had filtered initially, it's by using the top 10 filter over here. So for the first thing we're going to do is we're going to remove that filter because that's static and there's no way that we can change that to be dynamic. I mean, I wish I could drop in a measure over there and then we would just go to our selected N measure and just put that in there. Selected N just gives me return 5, 10, 15, 20, whatever selected, but it doesn't let me do that. In fact, I tried to add that as a filter. All right, so we're going to clear this filter because to kind of get started. So now we're seeing all customers. Now, how do we make this dynamic? Now, interestingly, top N has a cousin, which is rank X, and top N and rank X often, you know, kind of work in tandem. So that's our key. So we're going to define a rank measure, customer rank measure, and just follow along, watch me step by step to see how I do it. So let's go to modeling. I'm going to say new measure. All right. And we have, let's say, customer rank. And this is the standard, the rank X function. And the only catch with rank X is you might be tempted to say customer, but that, if you can try it out, it wouldn't quite work the way you expect. And you have to say all customer. I wouldn't go into the detail in this video as to why that's the case. So rank all customers by sales, and that is our customer rank function, and looks good. And we're gonna come back and move this new one to our formulas V3, since this is the part 3 of the video. And we're gonna add this over here. So you see we're getting somewhere with this. Now, only if you could tie this number, customer rank, to respect this one. Now, again, if we go look at the customer rank filter, there's no way to tie it to a dynamic measure. We can't say a customer rank is selected than a measure. So we can't quite do that. And again, it added that as a filter. So let me remove that. So what we're gonna do is take another step and add one more column, measure actually, which compares the customer rank with selected N. So let's do that. So we're gonna come back to formulas V3 and we say new measure, and we'll say is the customer rank within selected n? Less than selected n? We'll go with that. And we'll just say customer rank. Customer rank is less than equal to selected n. And that is our measure. Let's see how it performs. Let's add it on there. So you can see top 20, let's try top 10. So for top 10, you can see that selected n is 10. So up to 1 till 10, it is true. And after that, it is false. So this is good. This is really promising. And of course, if you change that to, let's say, top 5, perfect. So we can see top 1 through 5 ranks are true. And then it's false. So now we don't have to filter. We're not trying to do a dynamic filter. We can just say whenever this value is true, and that value, since that depends on the selected n, is going to be dynamic, right? I mean, you saw it's going to be 5 values are going to be true, and then 10 values are going to be true, and of course this is going to be top 50 and so forth. Although when you go into the customer rank and try to set a customer rank, the new field that we defined, customer rank within selected n, it actually doesn't let you do it. It's really weird, and I think that's a bug, and I filed that with the Microsoft Power BI team. Hopefully it'll be fixed soon. So we're gonna just change that a little bit, and we're gonna make this, instead of a true-false data type, we're gonna make this an integer, because somehow it seems true-false, it doesn't let me choose a filter, as a filter. So we'll say if customer rank is this, then 1, true, you know, or else 0. Or we could have said blank, doesn't really matter. And now if we go back to that field again, now we have that filter available to us. So let's go over here. And we're going to say not is less than, we'll say is 1. Oops, not. Let's try again. Is 1. And we're going to apply that filter. Are you ready, my friends? Woohoo! So now we're only seeing the top 10. Oh, there's a slight hiccup here, and we'll tackle that later, which is there are two Jordan Turners here. We're going to cover that in one of the follow-up of this top end series. For now, we're going to just bring in customer key to avoid that scenario. So that is our final solution. Let's just check to make sure it works. So we have top 10. It's only showing me top 10, and now it's showing me top 5, and I can change that to top 20 or top 15 or top 50 or top 100, and it still kind of shows me those number of customers. Now, of course, I don't need any of these fields in there. I don't even need kind of customer count, customer rank, customer that. I can just remove all of that. It'll still be in the filter pane, so I can remove it from the display. So I'm going to remove kind of customer count, customer rank, and customer, the last one that we had, which compared it to selected n, and it would still work. Actually, you know what? I'll come back. I'll keep customer count. That just helps me kind of see that it's working fine. And again, so it's not, you don't have to show that value, but it is in the filters for that. So, and that's what's making it work, that it's checking this value. Is customer rank within the selected n? You can get this file by going to learnpowerbi.com/download. Let me know what you thought about this video and the approach that I showed you today. Let me know what you thought about the top end series so far. You can access the complete playlist by clicking on the cards or down in the description below. Until next time, power on. Hey, keep watching more videos and keep learning Power BI. But if you did enjoy this video, I would love to hear from you. So leave a comment, like, subscribe, all the good stuff. Power on, my friends.